بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is part 41 of تفسير ابن كثير. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ثم قست قلوبكم من بعد ذلك فهي كالحجارة أو أشد قسوة. Then after that your hearts were hardened and became as stones or even worse in hardness. وَإِنَّ مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارُ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَشَّقَّقُ فَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ الْمَاءُ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَهْبِطُ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. And indeed, there are stones out of which rivers gush forth. And indeed, there are of them which split asunder so that water flows from them. And indeed, there are of them which fall down for fear of Allah. وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah is not unaware of what you do. The harshness of the Jews. Allah criticized the children of Israel because they witnessed the tremendous signs and the ayat of Allah, including bringing the dead back to life. Yet, ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. Then after that, your hearts were hardened. So their hearts were like stones that never became soft. This is why Allah forbade the believers from imitating the Jews when he said, أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ وَلَا يَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلُ فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدُ فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. Has not the time come for the hearts of those who believe, i.e. in the oneness of Allah and Islamic monotheism, to be affected by Allah's reminder, i.e. the Quran, and that which has been revealed of the truth, lest they become as those who receive the scripture, i.e. the Torah and the Injil, the gospel, before, i.e. the Jews and the Christians. And the term was prolonged for them, and so their hearts were hardened, and many of them were fasiqun, i.e. the rebellious, the disobedient to Allah. Quran chapter 57, verse 16. In his tafsir, Al-Awfi said that Ibn Abbas said, when the dead man was struck with a part of the cow, he stood up and became more alive than he ever was. He was asked, who killed you? He said, my nephews killed me. He then died again. His nephews said, after Allah took his life away, by Allah we did not kill him, and denied the truth while they knew it. Allah said, فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ أَوْ أَشَدُّ قَسْوَةً, and became as stones or even worse in hardness. And by the passage of time, the hearts of the children of Israel were unlikely to accept any admonition. Even after the miracles and signs they witnessed, their hearts became harder than stones, with no hope of ever softening. Sometimes springs and rivers burst out of stones. Some stones split and water comes out of them, even if there are no springs or rivers around them. Sometimes stones fall down from mountain tops out of their fear of Allah. وَإِنَّ مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارُ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَشَّقَّقُ فَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ الْمَاءُ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَهْبِطُ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. And indeed, there are stones out of which rivers gush forth. And indeed, there are of them which split asunder so that water flows from them. And indeed, there are of them which fall down for fear of Allah. Muhammad ibn Ishaq narrated that Ibn Abbas said that the ayah means, some stones are softer than your hearts. they acknowledge the truth that you are being called to. وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah is not unaware of what you do. Solid, inanimate objects possess a certain degree of awareness. Some claim that the ayat mentioned the stones being humble as a metaphor. However, Al-Razi, Al-Qurtubi, and other imams said that there is no need for this explanation because Allah creates this characteristic, i.e. humbleness, in stones. For instance, Allah said, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ فَأَبَيْنَا أَن يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَأَشْفَقْنَ مِنْهَا. Truly, we did offer al-amana, i.e. the trust, to the heavens and the earth and the mountains, but they declined to bear it and were afraid of it, i.e. afraid of Allah's torment. Quran chapter 33, verse 72. تسبح له السماوات السبع والأرض ومن فيهن. The seven heavens and the earth and all that is therein glorify him. Quran chapter 17 verse 44. والنجم والشجر يسجدان. And the stars and the trees both prostrate themselves to Allah. Quran chapter 55 verse 6. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا إِلَى مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ يَتَفَيَّأُ ظِلَالُ. Have they not observed things that Allah has created, how their shadows incline? Quran chapter 16 verse 48. قَالَتَا أَتَيْنَا طَائِعِينَ. They both said, we come willingly. Quran chapter 41 verse 11. لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى جَبَلٍ. Had we sent down this Quran on a mountain? Quran chapter 59 verse 21. And وَقَالُوا لِجُلُودِهِمْ لِمَ شَهِدْتُمْ عَلَيْنَا قَالُوا أَنطَقَنَا اللَّهُ. And they will say to their skins, why do you testify against us? They will say, Allah has caused us to speak. Quran chapter 41 verse 21. It is recorded in the Sahih that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, هَذَا جَبَلٌ يُحِبُّنَا وَنُحِبُّ. This mountain, i.e. the mountain of Uhud, is a mount that loves us and that we love. Similarly, the compassion of the stump of the palm tree for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as confirmed in authentic narrations. In Sahih Muslim, it is recorded that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِنِّي لَأَعْرِفُ حَجَرًا بِمَكَّةٍ كَانَ يُسَلِّمُ عَلَيَّ قَبْلَ أَنْ أُبْعَثَ إِنِّي لَأَعْرِفُهُ الْآنَ. I know a stone in Mecca that used to greet me with the salam before I was sent. I recognize this stone now. He said about the black stone that إنه يشهد لمن استلم بحق يوم القيامة. On the day of resurrection, it will testify for those who kiss it. There are several other texts with this meaning. The scholars of the Arabic language disagreed over the meaning of Allah's statement, فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ أَوْ أَشَدُّ قَسْوَةً, and became as stones or even worse in hardness. After agreeing that or here is not being used to reflect doubt, some scholars said that or here means and, so the meaning becomes as hard as stones and harder. For instance, Allah said, وَلَا تُطِعْ مِنْهُمْ آثِمًا أَوْ كَفُورًا, and obey not a sinner or a disbeliever among them. Quran chapter 76 verse 24. عُذْرًا أَوْ نُذْرًا, to cut off all excuses or to warn. Quran chapter 77 verse 6. Some other scholars said that or here means rather. Hence the meaning becomes as hard as stones, rather harder. For instance, Allah said, إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ يَخْشَوْنَ النَّاسَ كَخَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ أَوْ أَشَدَّ خَشْيَةً. A section of them fear man as they fear Allah or even more. Quran chapter 4 verse 77. وَأَرْسَلْنَاهُ إِلَى مِئَةِ أَلْفٍ أَوْ يَزِيدُونَ, and we sent him to 100,000 people or even more. Quran chapter 37 verse 147. And فكان قاب قوسين أو أدنى and was at a distance of two bows length or even nearer. Quran chapter 53 verse 9. Some other scholars said that this ayah means their hearts are only of two types, as hard as stone or harder than stone. Further, Ibn Jarir commented that this tafsir means that some of their hearts are as hard as stone and some hearts are harder than stone. Ibn Jarir said that he favored this last tafsir, although the others are plausible. I, Ibn Kathir, say that the last tafsir is similar to Allah's statement, مَثَلُهُمْ كَمَثَلِ الَّذِي اسْتَوْقَدَ نَارًا. The likeness is as the likeness of one who kindled a fire, Quran chapter 2, verse 17, and then his statement, أَوْ كَصَيِّبٍ مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ. Or like a rainstorm from the sky, Quran chapter 2, verse 19. This is also similar to Allah's statement, وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَعْمَالُهُمْ كَسَرَابٍ بِقِيَمٍ. As for those who disbelieve, their deeds are like a mirage in a desert. Quran chapter 24, verse 39. And then his statement, أَوْ كَظُلُمَاتٍ فِي بَحْرِ اللُّجِّ. Or the state of the disbeliever is like the darkness in a vast deep sea. Quran chapter 24, verse 40. This then means that some of them are like the first example and some others are like the second example. Allah knows best. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.